3D. Over the next few videos, I will be showing you guys how to create a basic pattern for you to use when creating a garment for yourself. Today I will be showing you how to create a basic pattern for the bodice, and in the next video it will be how to create a basic sleeve pattern. Before we start, I'm going to be going over a few points, including the equipment we need, the measurements we need to take, as well as how to take the measurements. Okay guys, for materials, you're going to need two pieces of cardboard. Now these are slightly larger than A2, and so I'll be using that. It probably is better to get a size as large as this. You'll be needing a piece of paper and a pen to note down your measurements, along with the measuring tape. You're also going to need a permanent marker. Permanent marker and a pencil. Pair of scissors and a ruler. Now I prefer using a 60 centimeter ruler, but a 30 centimeter ruler also works. And if you have one, a French curve, and that's just going to help us when we're drawing in the underarms on the pattern. Okay, now with the measurements. Our first measurement is going to be the full length measurement, which is from your shoulder to around your hip bone. So you take that measurement down and add a 2.5 centimeters to that. Then the next measurement we're taking will be the waist length, which is again from the shoulder point, and it's around the most cinched in part of your waist, so around here for me, and take that measurement down and you're leaving it as it is. The third measurement will be the waist width, and that's around your waist. Again, the most cinched in part of your body. And you're taking that measurement down and you're dividing that by 4 and adding a 3.5 to that, 3.5 centimeters. And then we've got our bust width, which is just over the nipple line. And you take that, divide that by 4, and again add a 3.5 centimeters. Okay, then we've got our hip width, and that's just over your hip bones. Okay, then we're measuring that, we're taking that down, and we're dividing that by 4 and adding a 3.5 centimeters to that as well. Now your last measurement will be your shoulder length, and we can take that, like, it's better to take from the back, and you can take that from shoulder to shoulder, but for this video I'm taking it from just below my neck, that bone, that spinal bone, putting one end of the measuring tape there and the other on your shoulder bone, so just around here. You're taking that measurement down and you're leaving it as it is. Okay, so then we've got three other measurements that we can't really measure on the body, but I'll give you the equation. It's really, really easy. It's your armhole measurement, and that's your bust divided by 4 minus 3.5. Then you've got your neck hold down measurement. So when we're doing the pattern, it'll be the amount from your collarbone down to whatever point so your head can fit through your garment, whatever you're making. And that is your bust measurement divided by 12 plus 3.8. Okay, so your last measurement will be your neck hole going across, which is on the pattern also helping you put your head through the garment. And that is your bust measurement divided by 12 plus 1.3 centimeters. Okay guys, now to make your basic pattern, you're going to get your piece of cardboard, one of them anyway, and you're going to fold that in half. And that's just so we can get a full size bodied pattern, but it's just easy to work off from one half of it anyway. Then we're going to get our ruler and measure our full length. For me, my full length is 51, and that's how large this cardboard is. So you may want to get something larger if your full length, if you're a taller person, that is. Then we're going to mark down our waist length, which is 37 for myself. So I'm just going to go down to 37. Whoops. Just mark that out. Okay, so the next measurement we're noting down will be the neck hole going down. For me, that's 11.68 centimeters, so that's around here. And then we're going across, and you can really use the 30 centimeter ruler usefully here. And that for me is 9.18, so that's just around there. And then using a French curve, you can do this on like freehand, but preferably using a French curve so you get a balanced curve. I'm just going to connect one point to the other. Okay, so the next measurement we're going to mark will be the armhole measurement, which for me is 21 centimeters, thereabouts. Yep. And then we're going to go across and measure your bust. Oh no, you're going to mark down your bust width. For me, that's 27.1. And then you're just going to drag that across. It's going to help. And on that same line, just measure down your shoulder length measurement. For me, that's 20 centimeters and 75. So just around there. Then we're going to go up here and measure your shoulder length again. And that's going to be, again, 20 centimeters. Just around there. And then we're going to connect the two dots, so the two marks on there and there. And just drag a line up. Now the next step will be measuring 1.3 centimeters from the top. Just around there. And connecting the point from your neck hole measurement going across to that. And we're going to draw a line there. So the next measurement we're going to be marking down is 2.5 centimeters from the bottom going up. And then getting your French curve, you're going to connect the dots from take the points from up here down to that point. And then from that point to the end of your bust line. Now you may have to move the French curve around to fit it. So I'm just gonna play around with this until I get it right. So it's sort of like that, because you want to dip into that line. Just underneath that line. Just freehand connect that together. Okay, so the next measurement we're going to be noting down is from the waist point, and we're going to take it across. For me, my waist width is 22.6, so find that here. Just draw a line from the end, and then we're going to go down to the bottom of the full length, and that's your hip measurement. So that's where your hip would be sitting around, and we're going to put the measurement onto the cardboard, and for me that was 28.4, so oops, that's around here. And then we're going to be connecting all three points to each other. So You can use a French curve, or you can do it freehand, or you can even just use a ruler and connect them so they're a lot angular. It doesn't really matter because when you're using fabric, it still just comes out nice and curvy, I guess. I am going to use my ruler because I'm used to that. I don't find a problem when it comes to sewing or cutting these patterns out. I find it a lot easier. Now remember, this is a basic pattern. It doesn't have any darts in it. And it just gives you your regular t-shirt if you want to have it as. Okay, and now all we are going to be doing is just cutting along these lines. And I'll get to that now and show you how it looks at the end. I'm just going to note down that this is the front of my basic pattern. Okay, now you're going to get your next piece of cardboard, which will be for the back pattern. You're going to fold that in half and just place your front pattern on top of it. You can use some glue tack to hold that down, but that's technically just it. Then you're just going to, with your pencil, measure down the points again. You can re-measure if you want, but you don't really have to. And then you're going to move this aside for a bit and connect the points. Right, back, basic pattern, and there you have it, your front and back basic pattern. And that's how you create a basic bodice pattern. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below in the comments section. And subscribe to my Spurious.